Even if you win in the rat race, you are a rat. Why do you want to be a rat? Understand, whether rat race or bullfight, rat fight, even if you win, see, you always want to prove and show you are a winner. That stupid ego will continue to keep you in the rat level. Understand that all fight destroys your life, your consciousness, your higher possibilities. Even when you strongly feel you are cheated, don't react. Even when you feel strongly injustice is done to you, don't abuse, don't react, don't have anger within you, don't have anger with others. If you enter into fight, if you enter into the trap of war, violence, taking revenge, proving yourself, gone. Even if you win, your life is gone, your inner space is gone, you will be in their level space. Understand? If I started my fight when I felt injustice is done to me in 2000 with one small local gang, I'll be still fighting with them, trying to prove my identity to them, trying to prove I am a big guy to them, which will be absolute waste of my life. Now they know I am too big guy. And I wanted to tell you guys the good news. They themselves came and surrendered the property. They came and voluntarily surrendered the property, saying that this place is too sacred and it should be celebrated by Swamiji and Swamiji's presence. Please tell Swamiji to take this and keep it with him. And we don't want to anymore involve into this small silly thing. And you understand, it really happened. Now, none of them are there. The people who threw me out, they are not there. And our puja is going on. Regularly our disciples are doing the puja and everything is in our hand now. I got that property also back. And I did what I need to do to the world. Because of my non-violence. I tell you, in every level, do not engage in war or fight. Do not get distracted, destroyed consciously. There is a saying. People try to tell, oh, my enemy decides what weapon I should pick up. It's like, oh, if he argues, I will also argue. If he legally fights, I will legally fight. If he picks up some other weapon, I will pick up that same weapon. I tell you, that is absolute foolishness. You will be in his conscious level. You will never have a breakthrough. Just go beyond. Do tyaga and become non-violent. You will set a different standard for yourself. If I was fighting with the people who threw me out of Thiruvannamalai, I would have been stuck with them. Or if I was fighting with the people who were chasing me from Tiruchengod, I'll be stuck with them. Or if I was waging the war with people who were trying to assassinate me in Bangalore, that gang, I'll be wasting my life. Even if I survive, I will not be able to do what I need to do. You see, these assassination attempts literally make you crippled. You can't come out, you can't teach, you can't speak. You cannot tell the real truth which you need to spread. See, I need to tell all the truths of Hinduism and initiate people, make people manifest powers. These assassination attempts continuously keeps all of us in fear. That I can't do my work. Even if I survive, even if I am alive, without doing the work, what is the use? That is why I decided I am not going to engage with them or trying to prove my supremacy to them. I decided I have to do my work. That is my first priority. doing work, whether I live or die, I don't care. By not doing work, whether I live or die, it is useless. So I decided, I'll find the right space and place to do my work, and I'll do my work. And I am successful. Paramashiva's blessings. Mahabhairava's blessings. Mahabhairava's protection. I won the game. So I tell you, when you do Tyaga, you are protected by Kalabhairava. I can see very clearly how. Not only that, when I did Tyaga, I am seeing so many of my sannyasis and disciples raising the standard of Tyaga. All of them are also raising in the standard of Tyaga. They are all just raising themselves. Hey, yes. This is the secret of success. This is the secret of success.